hello and welcome to the Open Education Network Summit. My name is Karen Lauritsen. I'm the Publishing Director with the Open Education Network, and I'd like to thank you for joining us for today's session so that you can get to know the new Manifold Pilot community at the OEN. We are delighted that you could join us today, and this is really an opportunity for us to thank you for the work that you do to make education more equitable, accessible, and affordable through open education. So thank you. Before we begin, I'd like to acknowledge I'm joining you from San Luis Obispo, California, which is the traditional, ancestral, and contemporary lands of the Northern Chumash. The Open Education Network is located at the University of Minnesota Twin Cities, which resides on Dakota land, ceded in the treaties of 1837 and 1851. We acknowledge the places from which we gather today have complex and layered histories, and I invite you to share a land acknowledgement in the chat if you wish. As we begin the session, I'd like to share a few other details with you. The session is being recorded, and the video transcripts and slides will be sent to attendees and the OEN Google group after the summit has concluded. Videos will also be posted on the Community Hub. This session is really meant to be an informal conversation, so we hope that you'll ask many questions. We may not have a chance to address all of them, but we're going to try our best. And you're also welcome to use chat to share comments or reactions. And Barb Thies, our Director of Community Engagement, will be keeping an eye on the chat together with me and the rest of the group. We're committed to providing a friendly, safe, and welcoming environment for all attendees. You can learn more about our community norms at z.umn.edu/summit-community-norms. Please join us in creating a safe and constructive space. The hashtag for the summit is OEN Summit 22, and you can join us on Twitter at OpenEd_network. As mentioned during the summit kickoff on Monday, each of our summit sessions relates to at least one of the OEN strategic planning action pathways. And today's session, ties in with both publishing and the OER revision and collection action pathways. And as part of our pathway development, we're actively rolling out new infrastructure, including Manifold, a web publishing platform, which is the focus of today's session. Now, I'm just going to share a little bit of background. At the end of last year, the OEN was selected as one of six organizations to join the Manifold community with a grant-funded support package, thanks to funding from the Andrew W. Mellon Foundation. The support includes 1 year of Manifold managed hosting, training, and support. And in addition, the OEN committed to providing another year of Manifold access. So we're in a 2-year pilot that will run through March 2024, providing participants with an extended opportunity to work on a range of open ed publishing, pedagogy, and curation projects so that they can work to meet the needs of their local communities. The pilot very officially launched at the beginning of this year. We welcomed more than a dozen institutions and organizations to experiment with Manifold. And together we went through the official Manifold training package. And we're now in the stage where we're getting active support from the Manifold team. And that includes Terrence Meyer at the University of Minnesota and Robin Miller at the City University of New York. They're also both here with us today, and we're thankful for their guidance. The plan is for the pilot group to share what they learn with us and make recommendations as to whether the OEN continues to offer Manifold beyond 2024. And today is really just our first opportunity to get an early report on how things are going. In addition to our featured guests, we are joined by others in our pilot community. And I'm sure that some of you in this group have Manifold experience of your own. So you are all welcome to share your experience as we move through the hour. Please don't hold back. To start, we will hear from 4 pilot participants representing a variety of institutional and organizational types and regions. They're going to take about 5 minutes, introduce themselves and their goals for the pilot, how it's gone so far, what they're hoping to achieve in the future. And then we will turn things over to you to get your questions and hopefully have a conversation. So today we're joined by Wayde, Interim Learning Commons and Library Coordinator at Leeward Community College and University of Hawaii Community Colleges. Amanda Gray, Open Education Strategist, Teaching and Learning Commons at Kwantlen Polytechnic University. Al Kuslikis, Senior Associate for Strategic Initiatives at American Indian Higher Education Consortium. And Kelly Smith, Director of Collections and Discovery at Eastern Kentucky University Libraries. So to get things started, I will hand things over to Wayde.
Hi, thank you, Karen. And thank you to you and the OEN for allowing the University of Hawaii Community Colleges to participate in the Manifold Pilot project. I'm part of a team of four. And so in addition to myself, there's Sunny Pai, who is a digital initiatives librarian at Kapi'olani Community College, Leanne Urasaki, an instructional technologist at Hawaii Community College, and Jason Yamashita, who is an OER librarian at Leeward Community College. I just wanted to take a couple of, maybe a moment or two to share our background. So I think that will help to understand why we are participating in this pilot project. So the UHCC system is comprised of seven campuses on four islands. We are part of an integrated public higher education system. So that also includes three four-year institutions. For the pilot, it is focused on the community colleges. And so we have a total enrollment about 16,000. Campuses range in size from 700 to about 5,000 students. So we are relatively small institutions and are very geographically dispersed. Our history in OER, two campuses started OER pilots back in 2014. In 2017, we started a system-wide OER initiative. And that was the same year that the community colleges joined the OEN as a consortium member. We have about 1 to 2 leads per campus. And they are typically either librarians, instructional designers, and a few instructors. We also have several academic deans who are designated leads who have more of a background role. So the leads are responsible for a lot of outreach activities, faculty support at their campuses. They might be the only person at their campuses supporting faculty with OER. And so while we have financial resources, dedicated time and experience to support publishing projects are varied and limited. And so nothing I've shared so far is unique to us, but it led us to our participation in the Manifold Pilot. So our first goal was to create a publicly accessible version of our OER 101 online asynchronous course for our University of Hawaii community. We started this six module online course back in the fall of 2021. We had about 42 faculty sign up and about 26 or so completed the course. It is housed in our Sakai-based LMS, which is a closed LMS. We don't have anything that allows us to share publicly the content within it. And this course was developed by Sunny and Leanne. And so we considered it to be a success. And so what we aim to do is to use Manifold to present this course in an open manner. So right now you are required to register for this OER 101. And so it limits the ability to share out this content, and not all faculty have the ability to devote a significant amount of time to completing a course. Our goal too is to identify an alternate textbook publishing platform that falls between Pressbooks, which UH has an instance of, and LibreText, and also Google Docs, which is how the University of Hawaii, that's the software and platform that we utilize the most. And so we're really exploring ways to allow our faculty to publish openly content that may include adapted content or original creations in an open manner. A lot of the content that our faculty Excuse me, that's my timer. A lot of our the content that our faculty currently produce are housed in La Lima, and so that doesn't offer great opportunity to share out this content. And so that's pretty much how we've come to our participation in the pilot. And we're so far very thrilled to be a part of it. And really what it's done to is allowed us to have these really deep discussions amongst our team about how we can better support our faculty with publishing in all the ways that faculty want to publish. So thank you so much for this time, and I will turn it off over to Amanda at Kwantlen.
Hello, so I'm Amanda Gray, as Karen introduced me. I'm an open education strategist at KPU, so working in the teaching and learning commons. And in the commons for open, we partner with KPU Library on open initiatives, primarily through our open publishing suite called Opus, which supports faculty who are publishing OERs. And it's our Opus team that's participating in this pilot. So currently our faculty are publishing OER on a variety of different platforms depending on the type of resource it is. So for example, textbooks are done in Pressbooks, which we have our own instance for. Videos are made in Kaltura. Some things have been uploaded to our institutional repository, but others haven't. And there's no centralized place that showcases the amazing resources that have been created. So we joined the Manifold Pilot Project to try creating a curated space where we can show off examples of good, interesting, or unique OERs, giving faculty a place where they can browse for inspiration and ideas. So what we are looking for from Manifold is a space where we can collect links to resources that live on other platforms, as well as upload resources that don't currently have a home. So a repository of sorts for OERs created at KPU. We came in with an idea of how we wanted the space to be organized and how we wanted it to look, but we quickly realized that because Manifold is not a content management system, we'd have to adjust our plans. So instead of the three-level organizational structure that we'd originally designed, we've simply created a collection for each type of OER. So we've got a collection for videos, we've got a collection for slide decks, interactive activities, and so forth. So what we're doing for this pilot is we've identified 2 to 3 example resources for each type and are experimenting with uploading them in different formats to see how they look and act within the collection. And so far, our repository is looking really great. Most of our difficulties have been the result of using a publishing platform for not publishing, but it's mostly working well, and we've been able to find workarounds for whatever issues do pop up. And our next steps for the repository is to finish uploading resources, which we're almost completed doing. And then we want to do some user experience testing to see whether or not the way that we've got it set up works and whether the repository is fulfilling its function. So that is a little bit about what we're doing with Manifold and where we're at in the process. So now I'll hand it over to Al.
Thanks, Amanda, very much. So I'm Al Kuslikis, Senior Associate for Strategic Initiatives at AHEC. And I'd like to start by acknowledging the Indigenous presence in the Washington, D.C. area where our office is, actually Northern Virginia, in Alexandria, Virginia. So we're surrounded by just over a dozen tribal nations that thrived along the Anacostia and Potomac River watersheds, the Chesapeake Bay area, and the states of Maryland, Virginia, and Delaware. These include the Piscataway, Pamunkey, Nuentego, and the Confederation of Sovereign Nanticoke Lenape Tribes. Our 37 tribal colleges and universities serve all the American Indian tribes in the U.S., across all the U.S. So we've been partnering with OEN now for a couple of years, primarily with David Ernst, who worked with us to develop some project ideas that have been funded by the Hewlett Foundation, essentially encouraging and supporting our 37 tribal college libraries, faculty in accessing OEN resources, and also helping to develop some OER content One project that we're working on right now, it's ongoing, is an introduction to environmental science that's indigenized, that incorporates indigenous perspective, indigenous understandings, and to a degree, traditional ecological knowledge that's not protected, of course. And so part of that also is an open pedagogy project where we're recruiting students to develop content in primarily in environmental science and environmental justice to contribute learning materials that would be shared by primarily tribal colleges, but the larger, broader OEN network as well. So our pilot, we're very early in our pilot. We're developing some usability requirements, some design ideas. Primarily, the two applications for Manifold that we're looking at, two projects are, one is the National Tribal University. So it's a vision that tribal colleges have had for a while, where courses and learning materials, curriculum, are shared across the entire partnership. We've got some really small institutions that have very limited faculty and limited programs. We have others that are offering master's degrees and developing PhD programs. We want to make sure that every program that represents a career pathway for students is available to all tribal college students. And so that the idea of having Manifold provide a resource for sharing content, sharing materials, sharing courses is really interesting to us. Right now, one project that we've got going is with funding from the Bay and Paul Foundation. Students are being funded for an REU to spend the summer doing climate change research in their community. We're looking at that as a driver for developing the OEN, OER content using digital media, video, podcasting, et cetera. The other project that's really newly emerging, we've been working on it for a bit with a whole broad set of climate change partners, but that we're calling the Tribal Resilience Access Hub. And the idea there is to develop a knowledge base around accessing national climate data resources, providing tools for working with that data, running queries on the data, specifically focused on tribal climate adaptation work. So having tribal colleges through Manifold develop or support a kind of an, what we're considering or we're thinking of as an innovation network, where our partners, tribal colleges, we've got CU Boulder's ESOL, the Environmental Data Science Innovation Inclusion Lab, NEON, the National Ecological Observatory Network, the University of Arizona's Tribal Resilience Center, and the NSF-funded Native Fuse Food Energy Water Systems Alliance, all collaborating to support tribal climate resilience and having this access hub be a both a resource for delivering training, access to data, and curriculum. So I know it's a blue sky. There's a lot going on in that needs to happen for that to actually work. So we're exploring how Manifold can be, what part of all this vision Manifold can provide, what part of the resources being delivered for this vision Manifold can provide. Let's see. So as I mentioned, we're still in the planning and exploration stages. We've got some great ideas and some great partners, and we're really looking forward to confirming or establishing Manifold as in some ways a centerpiece of our work. Let's see. Next steps, I think I mentioned doing the design and usability work, and we have we have four digital media courses that are going to be offered this fall by tribal college faculty, sort of a foray into the National Tribal University. And those, the projects that the students create in those courses, their introduction to digital storytelling, introduction to film production, 3D animation and introduction to interactive media, the products of that work will start to populate our open pedagogy vision for student-created content. In a nutshell, that's what we're doing. And I guess I'll hand it off to Kelly.
Thanks. That's awesome. So I'm a super visual person and I created slides. So I'm the only one, but that's okay. So I also would like to give a little background, like Wayde did, of how we got here to Encompass. Manifold. I would say we're a pretty young in the open space. We had our first department interested in writing in OER in 2017 to 2019. Our African American Studies program could not find an existing OER on the market, and they really wanted to use one. And so we offered that we could host it on our B Press platform. So we spent a couple of years working with them as they were writing that and preparing to publish that. We had our launch party in February 2020, right before COVID. So that was exciting. So then during the COVID period, 2020 to 2022, was kind of our scaling up phase with early adopters. And so we were focused on handing out grants for adoption and adaptation, and getting more folks involved in authoring and also just adopting OER for their classes. So the problem we've got now as we're scaling up is that our B Press repository has a really clunky architecture for what we need. There are, it's basically static PDFs. My colleague, Laura Edwards, who's also on this call, has done really all of this work in the platform itself, getting it to work and to look nice. And it's kudos to her. But it is limited in what it can do. There's no interactivity and multimodal stuff is really hard. So last year, the social work faculty came to us with a proposal. They all took the professional learning community that we gave as part of OER grants, and they wanted to create a hub sort of for multiple social work classes with a combination of various types of materials. So they wanted to include things that they had like straightforward adopted and then created ancillaries for. There was an adaptation project and there's also a faculty member authoring an original text. And they wanted that all in the same place. So we saw the Manifold pilot opportunity and decided to apply, and we're super excited to be working on this. Laura took the material that we had already. One of our social work faculty, Erin Stevenson, had uploaded ancillaries that she had created to go with an existing social work OER that's on the market. She uploaded the materials and it basically looked really great just right out of the box. And so there's just a professional appearance that that we appreciate. There's interactivity built in with social annotation. This is kind of an example. We're still playing around with this. We're early in the phase of, you know, getting stuff into Manifold and playing with it. But so we've uploaded this this document and we're experimenting with using it as kind of a peer review. So I'm going in and making comments about things that we might need to fix for the faculty member. But ultimately, what this can be used for is course interactivity. Students can sign up for reading groups and have discussions around the course material that's posted there. So this you can kind of see a little bit. This is kind of not a great screenshot, but so on the Manifold page, you've got up towards the top is the main textbook, and down below are materials that go with it. And there's just, it's very customizable the way you present it. And as I said, we haven't done any styling or anything to this. This is just out of the box. We just uploaded this material. In the future, so we have enjoyed doing this so much that we're going to continue populating our social work project here in the OEN pilot manifold instance, but we're also exploring going ahead and using open source manifold locally to do some other projects that would be really nice here. Like we have a astronomy faculty member who wants to upload some really high resolution sky images. And so that's the kind of thing that, that we're super excited to be able to do in Manifold. All right, I'm gonna stop sharing now. And that was quick and dirty introduction to us. So.
Okay, thank you, Wayde, Amanda, Al, and Kelly for those introductions. So we jumped right into it in terms of why they chose to join the pilot. And as I mentioned earlier, both Terrence and Robin, who are from the Manifold team, are here with us as well. So if you have questions about, wait a minute, back up, what can Manifold do? Please feel free to put any kind of question into the chat. In the meantime, Kelly, if it's all right with you, I'll share a link to your project in the chat.
Sure. I was about to do that.
Great. Yeah. This is one of the few projects that has been brought out of draft mode. So it is publicly available. There are lots of other projects in the works, but they're still in the works. So they're not live on the site quite yet. But that might give you an idea of at least what Kelly's working on or what's in store there.
I will say just a caveat, this kind of is our sandbox and we're okay with sandboxing publicly. So it's not exactly how we want it to be eventually, but it looks pretty good right now, we think.
Yeah, thank you. And it's really nice to have that public sandbox space. It's very helpful to see kind of the process and what's going on. And so maybe while I'm waiting for more questions in the chat, we can talk a little bit about process. So Wayde, I know you and your team, for example, have also done quite a bit of work experimenting with Manifold on a particular project. Is there something that you've, can you talk a little bit about what you've discovered in the process so far? Or Leanne, I know that you're here and you made a lot of discoveries. Maybe just hearing more about that would be helpful.
Sure. And I just wanted to piggyback on what Amanda had said earlier about, kind of shifting what our project looks like as we learn more about Manifold. And so, our project, our proposal is very focused, but definitely we're looking at the potential for Manifold to, host collections of materials. And as a community college system, one of the things that we've encountered is that not all faculty are interested in publishing a textbook. And so, looking for platforms that allow faculty to publish openly, but not necessarily have that huge learning curve that might be involved with creating a textbook. So I think that's where, my interest is how and can Manifold provide that platform for our faculty in a way that we can, realistically support them in this process. As far as our experience so far, I think, one of the things that we, and especially Leanne, who can come in here and share her experience, but one of the things that she's learned and we've learned is that, with Manifold, you have to have a project that's complete and ready for ingesting into the system. There's no ability in the current version to edit. And so what we've encountered, because with our LMS, we've pulled content, basically copied content from our LMS into a Google Doc and then uploaded that into Manifold. And there are some issues with the formatting that came up and we're having to kind of navigate. And so that is one thing that we've encountered with our experience so far. Definitely Leanne, if you wanna share some of your experiences with that whole process, please do so. I think that's probably one of the main issues that we're trying to navigate right now. Definitely, I think the annotation function, the ability to form reading groups and archive the reading groups is something that's very exciting, especially if we're looking at Manifold potentially to host collections of materials that faculty now house in our LMS.
Yeah, so thanks, Wayde. I just want to just go ahead and piggyback on that. Karen, I'm not really sure which link I post in the chat, which is why I kind of asked you. I was trying to doing this on the fly, but I went ahead and published our project. We had it as a draft and just published it now. So if anybody wants to take a look, Karen's going to try and grab that link and stick it in chat. Just because I think what we're doing is trying to actually publish a text. And so starting with the creation and the authorship of it rather than a collection of resources or a repository at this stage. And so we took what was in our LMS, which is basically, you know, HTML, it's already formatted for the web, but trying to get it out of that LMS and into Manifold. And so we started off with a Google Doc since we were collaborating across islands, across distance. And so getting it into a format we wanted, and then trying to get it from Google Docs into Manifold. And so we started there because Manifold can be created, you know, a project in Manifold can be created from a Google Doc. So we started there. And then we started learning the oohs and the ahs and the limitations and the challenges that we have with that process. And so we have a bunch of texts in our project because we went through a lot of different trials. And so we tried a Google Doc, we tried a Microsoft Word doc because that was another way to get content into Manifold. We tried creating an EPUB from our Google Doc and then uploading the EPUB. We tried an HTML document. I mean, you know, downloading HTML and putting that in there. And so you can see all of the different, I guess you can compare across those imports, what those look like, which might be helpful to some folks here, which is why I went ahead and published, although we're not anywhere near where we want to be. We haven't even played with the front, you know, the front cover, and we were just focused right now on getting the content in there and getting it to a place where it looks and acts the way we want it to. And so that's where our project is.
Thanks, Leanne. I dropped in a different project, still in draft mode, but I think I dropped in the published project that you were talking about. That's the OER 101 Go Open, Go Free, right?
Yes. And I'm so sorry, Ken, I didn't tell you what the name of our project was, but yes, okay. That's the one.
So I'm learning right alongside this whole pilot group. And so it's actually a lot of fun. Any questions for Leanne or our other guests so far? Feel free to unmute if you wish or drop it in chat.
I just have a comment, Leanne. That's great the way you guys are doing that, you know, to play around and see what the different kinds of uploads look like. Have you come to any conclusions yet about what's the easiest?
Well, I think the one that's going to probably look the best to me, and I know Terrence and Robin are both here, so grain of salt, guys. I think the one that's probably, I think would work the best is if you actually have a nice EPUB file and bring that in. So, you know, if you're bringing something over that you've already created and already have an EPUB file for, but, you know, our real vision is working with authors from scratch and trying to help them work in a place where they're comfortable and they don't have to learn yet another platform. Like they don't have to learn how to navigate Pressbooks or how to navigate LibreText or how to navigate something else, that they're already familiar and comfortable with Microsoft Word and with Google Docs. And so we wanted to find a way that we could allow our faculty to create where they're comfortable, but yet make the process from that original creation in that Google Doc or Microsoft the most pain-free to get it up and in a published version that can then be shared out. And, you know, because we touched upon the fact that we have very limited human resources, personnel that can support the publishing process, that we were trying to find something that we could support without taxing our resources too much. And so, you know, I think, like I said, the EPUB would be the best, but that would then create that whole level, a whole nother level, right? The faculty have to develop it, the content, and then figure out how to get it into EPUB. But the next best that we found is getting it out of Google Docs and downloading it as an HTML file and then uploading the HTML file. And that's where we're at now. And we're just working out, we're playing with that. So the HTML seems to be much better than working with the Google Doc or the Word Doc directly into Manifold.
I have one more question and then I'll be quiet.
Right.
Are you, Leanne, did the faculty do the alt text and other things like that? Or did you help with that? Or where in the process did you add the accessibility?
Well, for this particular project, Sunny, which is another one of our leads, and I developed the content that went into our LMS. And so we already had to apply all of the accessibility pieces to the content when we were putting it into the LMS. And so, that probably for things like alt text, for heading styles, for those low-hanging fruit on the accessibility tree would probably fall on the faculty. Whereas I think, when we talk about captioning, if they're creating original videos and stuff, that might be a heavier lift for faculty where we might need to find some additional resources to help with that. But I think the alt text, especially since alt text is so personal and customized, right? It's really what the faculty envisioned for the purpose of that content, that I think that has to stay on the faculty for at least for now.
Thanks for your questions, Kelly. And it's great to listen in on, the intra pilot communication. So if you want to ask one another questions, that is also very welcome. I think I might put Terrence and Robin on the spot since they're both here. If you're willing, you could talk a little bit about, how you see Manifold used. There's the CUNY example, of course, University of Minnesota Press, which you're both involved with respectively. And then maybe what you've observed so far in working with the OEN community, and if there have been any new ideas or surprises or things that have come up through this process with us so far.
I'll let Robin go first.
You beat me to it. I was going to say Terrence can go first. I think in some ways what has been, and I love working with this whole group because it's so many of the kind of interactions that I do every day. I support the 25 campuses for the City University of New York, and we have an instance that we do. So almost all our work is OER. It's courses, it's coursework. We do have some traditional textbooks, so we may have some projects that are just one text, but a lot of it is folks who are, this is the first time they've sort of entered the world of publishing. So it's really exciting to work with the folks at OEN and to also hopefully help you, kind of support you through and say, hey, we've heard this before. I know Terrence and I take all of your comments back to our team meetings and talk with them and to say like, hey, we're seeing this come up again and again. This is something, how can we work through this? The resources question, all of us come to the table of OER with different resources, right? Human resources, technology, all these different things. So I am so grateful to hear from all of you about how you are kind of working with this, and kind of how do you work through this? And I think for this whole summit has been amazing to think about sort of shared abundance, right? And, kind of how we can share our skills and work through. It's something we think about from the Manifold team as well. But all of the things and all of the questions and all of your struggles as you try to find the best ways and the best formats to, ingest things into Manifold and to create projects. I'm hoping that we can provide, by having at least the five formats, it kind of gives a few different pathways for people to get materials in and, to hopefully get these projects going. But just know that it's a pleasure working with all of you, and we're here for you if you have questions, and we certainly understand your struggles because they're kind of the same across the board.
Yeah, I'd echo that. I'd say that it's been a really rich experience, because hearing your pain points and seeing where the concerns are coming up, and just kind of the content that you're working with and where you're sourcing it from, is really helpful for us as a Manifold team to better understand that. I mean, knowing that a lot of times you're trying to go to sources that are purely PDF and trying to back out of that and put that into a platform where you have rich, reflowable text. Even for folks who do this day in and day out, and professional publishers, that's not easy. I mean, that's never easy. And so trying to find ways to like lower the barriers and make your work easier are things that are very much on our mind. No promises, but I can definitely say that we very much hear you, and we are, I want to say we're pretty close to where we want to point the Manifold ship going forward. And I see editing mode as a very likely possibility for the next version of Manifold, so that once you do have content in the system, you will be able to adjust it directly there without having to go back to the source text and re-ingest it, as well as opening up some more options around the kinds of resources that you can bring in, as opposed to having to find those workarounds and to be able to do it more naturally. So all that feedback is super, super useful. I know our lead developer is very keyed in on making the reader interface even more versatile and robust to display dynamic content. So if you aren't, you know, a publisher that's looking to, you know, go into the print space, you can portray content in Manifold that might have, and I'm just going to be kind of generic here, like a Jupyter notebook in the middle of the text or something like that, where you could engage with that kind of content directly in that space. And so I see those as pathways of just having reviewed the work that you all are doing here. It's going to inform what we're doing. So definitely going forward. And all these ideas are fantastically exciting. These presentations were great. Robin and I were kind of like DMing one another on the down low, listening to all of you. It's just fantastic and exciting. We want to be able to help and support all of you.
Well, you have both been very helpful and supportive. Thank you. We are all a member of a Google group now, the OEN Manifold Pilot Google group, and it's a very active group. There's a lot of support being offered to one another and from Terrence and Robin. And we've been very fortunate to have them as partners and supporters. Did I interrupt somebody? No, okay. So Amy, thank you so much for your big picture question. Questions of any picture size are welcome. So why don't we start with the presenters? I'm really interested to hear your thoughts on where you think the open ed community and or your institution may be headed in the next few years. There are a lot of platforms out there. Amy mentioned several: Pressbooks, of course, which is well established, LibreText, which is adding functionality. We just had a presentation this morning with Editoria and the Open Textbook Builder. And so, you know, how do you wrestle with all of these innovations and tools? You've talked a little bit, panelists, about, you know, wanting to work with faculty in a way that's supportive, but that faculty may not want to be learning these new tools. So how are you navigating this complicated landscape?
I can start. I have some ideas. So for me, the question is like, what's my purpose? And I think each of these platforms and tools have meet a different purpose. And so, for example, the textbook authoring tool that we did in the previous session is not a platform. It's not really competing with these things. It's supplementing it. So, you know, that could be a space where our faculty create something, and then it's pretty easy for us to export it as an EPUB and put it into Manifold. When I think of Pressbooks and LibreText, I mean, they're both great and fantastic, but they don't have the same scannability and, I don't know, visual presentation that works for the multimodal stuff that we're getting from Manifold. So if I hear a faculty member saying they just want to do basically a straightforward traditional textbook, like Pressbooks might be the best option for that. But for something else, we might want to go with Manifold. I do hope there's not a huge platform proliferation. Like, I think a few really good ones is good. But those are my thoughts.
I guess I can make a few comments on the part of AIC and tribal colleges. You know, we're really too early to be comparing the different technologies and the publishing platforms and all that. Our vision really, though, is to establish and foster this a collaboration ecosystem where faculty, students, and partners from the federal agencies and major, you know, mainstream higher ed institutions are as needed focusing resources to solve problems, you know, pedagogical problems, participatory science in the community problems having to do with, you know, right now it's a big priority for us, climate change, getting tools into the hands of stakeholders out in the community. And, you know, the whole education enterprise supposedly is supposed to stand up, you know, the capability of communities and societies to evolve and develop solutions as needed. So I guess I'm being a little bit 20,000 feet here, but tools like Manifold and other and strategies like open education, resource sharing, those are all. They all fit very well into this idea of a collaboration ecosystem, which obviously OEN is. So it's to me and to many of us at AIC, that's really the future of this infrastructure is needed to be put in place to support, you know, getting resources out where they're needed and partners, facilitating partnerships where they're needed. So that's a long way of saying that we're figuring it out. Oh, trying to.
I can ramble for a few minutes. I guess my answer to the question is I have no idea. I've got a few thoughts about it. One being that competition drives innovation, right? So you mentioned LibreText adding functionality, right? LibreText was one of the first publishing platforms out there. And as competitors like Manifold and Pressbooks established, now LibreText is now upping its game in order to compete, which I think is really, really good, having innovative platforms. However, there's also a risk that institutions that support specific platforms, as we develop resources on how to use these platforms, as we figure out support structures, we risk becoming fixed and stuck with that platform to a point where the idea of switching to another one is too much work. So then we get stuck with what we have been using just because we don't have the we just don't have the capability of switching. So I love the innovation, but I worry about consolidation and having one platform do everything. I think what we need to focus on as people who support open publishing is flexibility and encouraging a range of tools rather than just saying, well, everything needs to be made. In our example, everything needs to be a Pressbooks. I think that's really important for us.
I can share my thoughts, and I don't have big picture thoughts. My thoughts focus on, you know, how to best support my faculty. But coming out of the earlier presentation today with the textbook builder tool and editorial, right? You know, just thinking about the various ways each of these platforms can support our faculty in however they want to publish their content, right? You know, some of it is specific to how our the platforms that we have came about, and others are just based on what faculty want to publish and how they want it to be presented to them. And so I do think the flexibility is important. I do think that, you know, going in, one concern was that we're going to spread ourselves too thin because we couldn't support our faculty in the platforms we already have. But I do think that Manifold and some of the other platforms, the one that OEN is also looking to pilot, will offer that flexibility. And depending on the faculty's need and their the time investment, the support at the campus level, you know, there's going to be one platform that will be the one that will work for them and that can be supported. And so for us, it's a matter of now taking a look at all of these platforms that we have, deciding on how we're going to develop the specific workflows to support our faculty in these areas. And then to be very cognizant and aware of which ones we can support and how much we can provide the support that faculty are looking for. And so I think that's my on the ground kind of thinking about how these platforms might kind of work together to support our needs here.
Thanks for that great question, Amy, and thanks to everyone for sharing your thoughts. It's really nice to sort of carve out space to reflect on this together and the different tensions that are inherent in, you know, wanting to do a lot to support so many pressing issues in our society, including, like Al was saying, climate change, wanting to support students, wanting to support faculty, knowing that we have limited resources, that we may not have a position even dedicated to OER publishing support, as Leanne said in the chat. And so, you know, that's really at the forefront of our minds at the OEN, is looking for ways that we can, together as a larger community with all of our abundance, support one another in some of these sort of tough situations that we find ourselves in. So there's more conversation in the chat, particularly about, you know, sharing different multimedia and multimodal content. Kelly, do you want to say anything more about the buffet approach?
Yeah, I mean, it's hard visual. I mean, if we had a, like, we need to just get Terrence to, like, pull up his screen and, like, show the different things. But, like, so when you're in the back end of Manifold, it's kind of like if you've ever worked in WordPress or something, and there's, like, blocks that you can put in different ways and move around. So you can have, you know, at the top, if it does have a textbook that it's centered around, there's the textbook at the top, but then there's all these other different opportunities for putting content in a way that, at least for the projects that my faculty are working on, that's the kind of thing they wanted. Like, they didn't want to have necessarily just a print analog type thing in a virtual environment. So that's kind of what I was talking about. Manifold makes that easier.
Thanks.
Can I jump in and say, I feel like this is a perfect time for my example of the stacking lunchbox, right? So a Manifold project is like a stacking lunchbox, and you have that, it's a container, and then you have all these different sections that are specific to different types of things. And so if your project is just one thing, maybe you just have, just like lunch, maybe you're just eating one thing, so you have just one small thing. But maybe you want to have some cold food and some hot food and some liquid food. So you have all these different stacks that you can sort of build up that are built specifically for that, whether that's a resource or whether that's a text or any of that. So I'll jump off, but I love to throw my stacking lunchbox in.
Thanks, Robin. I dropped the example from getting started with Manifold at CUNY as an example into the chat. If there are other examples that you'd like to share to illustrate, that would be great. Any more requests? We have about 5 minutes left. Kelly suggested maybe we have a brief demo from Terrence, really put him on the spot. but I will leave that to our participants. I need some kind of signal in the chat that that may or may be of interest, or we can thank our guests and say our farewells. Terrence is sharing a great demo project that shows off blocks. Thank you, Terrence. I pulled up what was bookmarked in my browser, which is getting started with Manifold. Okay, well, I will begin my wrap up. I just want to thank Kelly, Amanda, Al, and Wayde for joining us today and for joining us in the pilot. I know that it takes a certain amount of, a sense of adventure to join a pilot and be willing to experiment with a new tool when you're not sure where the tool is going to go in 2 years or how it's going to go. And it's just been really delightful working with the entire group so far. And again, these are early days, so stay tuned for more updates from the OEN Manifold Pilot community. Thank you all for joining us today. This has been a conversation around our strategic planning action pathways. And as we move forward with building out each pathway, we invite you to share your related projects you may be working on or ideas that the summit has sparked for you on the community share document. Barb will drop that document into the chat now. We also encourage you to keep the conversation going in the Google group. And finally, just a friendly reminder that the session has been recorded and will be shared with you via email and in the community hub, along with slides and transcripts. So thank you again, everyone, for coming together today, and look forward to seeing you soon. Farewell.
Thank you.